morning and welcome to St. Mark's on this, the fourth Sunday of Lent. Worship would not be the same without each and every one of you here this morning. We're so glad you're with us today. Our service continues with a penitential order, beginning on page 351 in the Book of Common Prayer and on page 3 of your bulletin. Bless the Lord who forgives all our sins.
God's mercy endures forever.
Please kneel as able. Hear the commandments of God to God's people. I am the Lord your God who brought you out of bondage. You shall have no other gods but me.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. You shall not make for yourself any idol.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. You shall not invoke with malice the name of the Lord your God.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. Remember the Sabbath day and keep it holy.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Honor your father and your mother.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
You shall not commit murder.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. You shall not commit adultery.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
You shall not steal.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
You shall not be a false witness.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
You shall not covet anything that belongs to your neighbor.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Therefore, let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. Please stand as able. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Gracious Father, whose blessed Son, Jesus Christ, came down from heaven to be the true bread which gives life to the world, evermore give us this bread, that he may live in us and we in him, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated for the readings.
A reading from the book of Numbers. From Mount Hor they set out by the way to the Red Sea to go around the land of Edom. But the people became impatient on the way. The people spoke against God and against Moses. "Why have you brought us up out of Egypt to die in the wilderness? For there is no food and no water, and we detest this miserable food." Then the Lord sent poisonous serpents among the people, and they bit the people, so that many Israelites died. The people came to Moses and said, "We have sinned by speaking against the Lord and against you. Pray to the Lord to take away the serpents from us." So Moses prayed for the people. And the Lord said to Moses, "Make a poisonous serpent and set it on a pole, and everyone who is bitten shall look at it and live." So Moses made a serpent of bronze and put it upon a pole, and whenever a serpent bit someone, that person would look at the serpent of bronze and live. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. You are dead through the trespasses and sins in which you once lived, following the course of the world, following the order of the power of the air, the spirit that is now at work among those who are disobedient. All of us once lived among them in the passions of our flesh, following the desires of flesh and senses. And we were by nature children of wrath, like everyone else. But God, who is rich in mercy, out of the great love with which he loved us, even when we were dead through our trespasses, made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved, and raised us up with him and seated us with him in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus, so that in the ages to come he might show the immeasurable riches of his grace and kindness toward us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not your own doing, it is the gift of God, not the result of works, so that no one may boast. For we are what he has made us, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand to be our way of life. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus said, "Just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. Those who believe in him are not condemned, but those who do not believe are condemned already, because they have not believed in the name of the only Son of God. And this is the judgment, that the light has come into the world, and people love darkness rather than light, because their deeds are evil. For all who do evil hate the light and do not come to the light, so that their deeds may not be exposed. But those who do what is true come to the light, so that it may be clearly seen that their deeds have been done in God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. For God so loved the world. What's the first thing that comes to your mind when you hear those words? Do you remember when you first heard them, or who it was that first taught them to you? Did you memorize that verse in Sunday school? Was there somebody in your life who had a habit of repeating that phrase? And how many times do you think, especially in this part of the world, have you seen those words plastered on billboards, posters, marquees, everywhere from churches to roadsides to stadiums? For God so loved the world. There might not be a more widely known and widely cited verse in all of Scripture than that of John 3:16. And we should say, there's no shortage of commentary on it either. Sermon series galore. You might at this point see where this is going and feel your eyes start to roll back in the back of your head. John 3:16 again? I'd wager you're not the only one thinking that. We've been here before. We know it. We've heard it. Sometimes, though, y'all, a love letter is worth reading again, isn't it? When our gospel begins today in John, Jesus is in mid-conversation. See, Nicodemus has come to him in the night, searching for clarity on Jesus' divine identity. And as part of his response to Nicodemus' questions, we get those well-known words straight from the mouth of Jesus in John's gospel. For God so loved the world that God gave his only Son, that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. And then he goes on, "Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him." Yeah, a love letter indeed. See, the story of God and humanity, it seems, can be viewed one of two ways. Either it's a story of reprimand and punishment for forever missing the mark since we partook in that forbidden fruit. Or it's a love story in which God is forever reaching out to humanity, and humanity, fallen though we are, when we're at our best, we are reaching right back out to God, a reaching towards right relationship that we know somehow in our bones will save us. Notice, Jesus goes on to say that he was love sent into the world not to condemn it, but in order that all the world might be saved through him. St. Thomas Aquinas seems to sum it up when he says this: grace does not destroy nature. It perfects it. Because God's love story, God's story is a love story with the world. God created us out of love, after all, and it was good. God then covenanted with us out of love. And every single time we got it wrong, God reached out and tried again. Adam and Eve, Noah, Abraham and Sarah, Moses, just to name a few. Take a look at the history of God's covenant with the humanity that God created. And well, then, it just makes sense that God's Son would come not to condemn this world, but to save it. Because saving through love and perfecting through grace is exactly the kind of business that God is in. Presiding Bishop Michael Curry is fond of saying this: if it is not about love, it's not about God. For God so loved the world. See, that's why this verse is so popular, why it's so memorized, so accepted, because God is love. And God has so much love for this world with abundant grace to perfect the very nature of things from the beginning to kingdom come. You've noticed by now that we've started every service in Lent with the Decalogue, where we read and hear again the Ten Commandments as they're found written in Exodus and Deuteronomy. Would you believe me if I told you this morning that that too is a love letter from God to humanity? Maybe not at first blush, but take a closer look and see that what might sound at first like the tough love of commandment is also real love that gives us some parameters in the way we are to love and be with one another. It's a love that sets the stage, that builds an arena where love is, in fact, the way, where mutual respect is expected, where relationship is the currency. Love that is real, that has legs enough to stand on. It's a love that very really saves the world. I mean, y'all, we do this thing every week. We dress up, we play beautiful music, we sing all these songs, we build these fancy, beautiful buildings because we believe that, right? That God still loves this world. Even, we say, as wars rage in the holiest of lands, God still loves this world. Even as the ever-playing news cycle tries to convince us that all hope is lost, we say God still loves this world. Even as political pundits scream from both sides of the aisle, we believe God still loves this world, even as we fall short. In our call to love God and love neighbor, we know God still loves this world. And if we believe that, I mean, only just a little bit, then it is our duty to take that love into a world that has forgotten. Forgotten that it was founded in love, created by love, is and will be saved by that very love. Which, my friends, is exactly why it still matters that we hear these well-traversed verses, these well-traveled truths, and remember the message that God loves the world, that God will save this world, that God believes in this world. Wouldn't it be something then if we believed in God as much as God believed in us? For God so loved the world. In the end, maybe that's what this whole Lent thing is about. This whole church thing is trying to preach and teach and be that the whole Christian movement was and is and where we're called to go a testament and a witness to that ever-present, always available divine love. The love that sent Christ to dwell among us. The love that propelled Jesus in his earthly ministry. The love that held him as he hung from the cross. God's love that leads us, that carries us, that holds us in the wildernesses of our own lives. A love that sets us free. A love that brings us on back home. How about that for a love letter, y'all? Thank God. Thank God that God loves this beautiful, broken world. For God so loved the world. Amen.
Amen.
Standing together as able, let us reaffirm our faith through the words of the Nicene Creed, found on page 358 in your Book of Common Prayer and page 10 of your bulletin. We believe in one God, the Father of the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Prayers of the People are Form 5 and are found on page 389 in the Book of Common Prayer and in your bulletin on pages 11 through 13. In peace, let us pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, have mercy for the Holy Church of God, that it may be filled with truth and love and be found without fault at the day of your coming. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, Michael, our presiding bishop, Rob, our bishop, and Andrew, our rector, for all bishops and other ministers, and for all the holy people of God, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who fear God and believe in you, Lord Christ, that our divisions may cease, and that all may be one as you and the Father are one, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the mission of the church, that in faithful witness it may preach the gospel to the ends of the earth, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the world, that a spirit of respect and forbearance may grow among nations and peoples, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those in positions of public trust, we pray for Joe, our president, Brian, our governor, Quay, our mayor pro tem, and our county commissioners and city councilors, that they may serve justice and promote the dignity and freedom of every person. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For a blessing upon all human labor and for the right use of the riches of creation, that the world may be freed from poverty, famine, and disaster. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the poor, the persecuted, the sick, and all who suffer, for refugees, prisoners, and all who are in danger, that they may be relieved and protected. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this congregation, that we may be delivered from hardness of heart and show forth your glory in all that we do. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our enemies and those who wish us harm, and for all whom we have injured or offended, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For ourselves, for the forgiveness of our sins, and for the grace of the Holy Spirit to amend our lives, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who have commended themselves to our prayers, for our families, friends, and neighbors, that being freed from anxiety, they may live in joy, peace, and health. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the special needs and concerns of this congregation. For all those who are in military service, especially John, Dustin, Patrick, Kevin, Colin, Jacob, and Jamario. For those who are on our parish prayer list, especially Robert, Jessica, Deborah, Sharon, Laura, Deborah, Janet, Gabby, and Curtis, Heather, Pam, Mackenzie, Linda, Beth, Michael, Richard and Joanne, Sydney, Baby Samuel, Julia, Kathy, William, Michael, and others whom we name silently or aloud. For those celebrating birthdays this week, especially Judy, Noah, and Marcia. For those celebrating wedding anniversaries this week, especially Joel and Van. Lord, have mercy. For all who have died in the communion of your church, and those whose faith is known to you alone, that with all the saints they may have rest in that place where there is no pain or grief, but life eternal. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Rejoicing in the fellowship of all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and all our life to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
Prayers of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Please stand as able. My friends, the peace of the Lord be always with you. Please be seated. Come on, Marjorie. We'll kick it off with this blessing. And while Marjorie's getting the corporals, I'll just say I saw something posted today that said, okay, I'll wake up an hour earlier, but I'm not spring-forwarding to anything. I'm going to roll sleepily through the day. So good job being here on time today. We've got some new corporals, before we get into the announcements, this is not a liturgical test, just to let you know that corporals are the placemat. They're the placemat. That is a table, after all, and so much more, right? So this is the placemat. We've got some new ones, and we're going to bless them and then put them to use. Let us pray. O glorious God, all your works proclaim your perfect beauty. Accept our offering of these corporals and grant that they may adorn this sanctuary and show forth your glory. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Want me to take it? That's right. Lent continues. We have morning prayer at 9 a.m. here in the church, Monday through Friday. Join us if you have or have not been doing that. Soup and sermons continue as we're looking at Michael Curry's highlight reel. We have two more weeks of that. That's right after our 5:30 evening Eucharist on Wednesdays. Mary Ann Wilson has one more Sunday school session. What are we reading next week? I'm thinking about giving Mary Ann my sermon themes for the week so she can give some teasers. What do you think? Thank you for that. EYC meets for our 6th graders through 12th graders, meets this evening at 5 o'clock. Let any 6th through 12th grader know. And if you're not a 6th through 12th grader, send us some prayers. We will begin painting the youth room. So some prayers, please. Thank you. Prayers and luck and whatever else you got. Holy Week is coming up. Mentioned this last week. We'll start Holy Week on Palm Sunday at the Celtic Cross. We'll process in as Jesus processed into Jerusalem, and then we will walk through that week. And I just encourage you to join us as we walk with Jesus to Golgotha, to the cross, and to the empty tomb. On Wednesday, we'll have a 5:30 service of Tenebrae. Has anyone ever been to a Tenebrae service? It's an old service. It's a service of shadows, and it's sort of similar to a Lessons and Carols, if you've ever been to that. So there'll be some readings, there'll be some call and response, and then choral and congregational Tazze-type chants with lots of candles and that sort of thing. So join us for that. Then Monday, Thursday, we'll be at 5:30 with foot washing and stripping of the altar. Good Friday at noon here. We'll have a Holy Saturday service in the morning for those setting up for Easter at 9 a.m. here, and then our vigil. It's been Sunday morning in the past. It'll be Saturday evening. That is, in fact, the oldest, just so you know, the oldest service in our Book of Common Prayer. So we're going to lean into that tradition and do it the eve of Easter. Easter vigil at 8 p.m., and then Sunday morning service, 8:30, regular service, then egg hunt in the backyard, and then 10:30 service. So join us for any and all of that, please. And finally, y'all know I'm not good at thank you notes, but my mama did teach me to say thank you. She taught me to write them too, but I don't do that. You already know that. I've said that I won't call people out every time they come to visit, but this is a special deal. I wasn't going to cry. That's not true. I was, of course, going to cry. You know me well enough to know that. And then Robin picked, like, the greatest hymns in our hymnal today, so it's got me feeling a certain kind of way. Ken Struble and Melanie Struble are here visiting, and Ken was camp director at Camp Michael for the last 20-plus years. He and Melanie, I don't know, Julie, what do you got to say? They they taught us how to be a priest and family. They knew that we loved each other before we knew we loved each other, Julie and I. So the most important thing is any and all complaints, please send it directly to them. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God. stand as able. Service continues with Eucharistic Prayer A, beginning on page 361 in your Book of Common Prayer and page 15 of your bulletin. This is God's table, and all are welcome. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who was tempted in every way as we are, yet did not sin. By his grace, we are able to triumph over every evil and to live no longer for ourselves alone, but for him who died for us and rose again. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn, to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love, you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you, in your mercy, sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. This is the table, not of the church, but of Jesus Christ. It is made ready for those who love him and for those who want to love him more. So come, you who have much faith and you who have little, you who have been here often and you who have not been for a long time or ever before, you who have tried to follow and you who have failed. Come not because the church invites you. It is Christ, and he invites you to meet him here. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries that we are living members of the body of your Son and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now, Father, send us out to do the work you have given us to do, to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. May the road rise with you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face. May the rain fall soft upon your fields. And until we meet again, may God hold you in the hollow of God's hand. The blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit is with you this day and will be evermore. Amen. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.